Temporary Pipework Training, December 2020. Introduction, objectives. To define what is temporary pipework, to identify the hazards associated with temporary pipework, to review methods for mitigating the risks posed by temporary pipework operations, for ensuring a safe operation while using temporary pipework. What is temporary pipework? Temporary pipework, treating iron, is piping and flow line equipment that is mobilized to the worksite for performing different pumping or flowing operations. Temporary, in the context of pipework and flow line equipment, applies to any pipework which can be changed out without recourse to formal structural or process engineering design reviews. Temporary pipework is manufactured for use in either standard or sour service. Temporary pipework consists of the conduits and equipment for directing fluids, liquids or gases from a pump to a Christmas tree, a high pressure point to a lower pressure point. Fluids directed to outlets ending with plugs on which sensors are mounted. Temporary pipework is piping and flow line equipment that is mobilized to the worksite for connecting or hooking up equipment for the following operations. General pumping operations, transfer of fluids, mud brine mixing operations, reverse circulating well fluids, etc. Pressure testing of downhole equipment, casing, packers, tubing, plugs, valves, accessories, cementing, well killing, well stimulation, nitrogen pumping, well cleanup, flowbacks, well testing, underbalance drilling operations, managed pressure drilling operations. Temporary pipe work can be both hard and flexible pipe. Equipment involved: pipework runs, straights, pipe joints, elbows, T-pieces, laterals, Y-pieces, swivel joints, treating loops, crossovers, high pressure hoses, flanges, blind plugs, tapings for sensors, sample points, etc. What type of connections? Hammer type connections, hub type connections, flange connections, pipe body to pipe body, welded, or pipe body to sub. Gas welded, friction welded, thread pipe body to sub, NPST, no pressure seal on the thread, PST, pressure seal on the thread. Equipment setup. Thank you. hammer unions and operational hazards. Female, male subs or union parts. Female sub and a male sub of hammer type union. The union parts are called out, using a nominal pipe size, a FIG designation, and a code EG1502. For example, 3 in, FIG 1502, the 3 in, is the nominal diameter and is close to the inside diameter. The meaning of FIG is probably an abbreviation of figure, meaning drawing, and 1502 is a code for the working pressure rating, 15, referring to 15,000 psi. The addition of H2S pipework has led to the designation becoming corrupted. 3 in, FIG 1502 H2S service pipework ordered from the major flow line equipment providers has a cold WP rating of 10,000 psi. The last two digits in the designation of hammer unions generally refer to the sealing arrangements. 02 refers to a square gasket seal, 06 refers to an O-ring seal. Pressure. In temporary pipework operations, low pressure is often used for values of around 300 psi, that is 10 times that of a car tire, and the operating pressure may be above 10,000 psi, that is 10,000 pounds exerted on every square inch of the inside of piping, unions, swivel joints, crossovers, etc. in the system. Stored energy. Stored energy is the capacity of a volume of pressured fluid to do work if allowed to expand. An example of this work would be a volume of pressurized gas expanding and pushing a piston. The greater the stored energy of the fluid, the greater the force with which the piston would be pushed and the greater the amount of work that piston could perform. The danger associated with stored energy in temporary pipework is that the stored energy is typically very large, and any the weak point in the system will allow this energy to discharge with potentially catastrophic results. Dynamic loading: when the pipe fails, the strain on any restraint when it snaps tight to restrain the pipe is called the dynamic loading by process engineers. The rule of thumb used to work out this dynamic loading is twice that due to the static force on the pipe arising from internal pressure. Vibration. Vibration can be a significant risk to pipework integrity, leading to mechanical failure, fluid release, and potentially serious safety implications. Common areas of vibration in temporary pipework are long pipe runs, piping fixtures and instrumentation such as gauges, equipment such as valves, chokes, etc., pumps. Common causes of vibration include excessive pulsation from pumps, for example, mechanical natural frequencies, inadequate supports and/or support structure. Common effects of vibration include loosening of bolts, compromising of mechanical joints, backing off of wing nuts, movement or slackening of tie downs and restraints. Bending forces. Temporary pipework is commonly subjected to bending forces due to fluid velocity and the internal pressure of the pipe. Bending force occurs at junctions or bends in the pipework where it effectively tries to straighten out the bend. Such bending forces are then transferred along the pipework and result in additional strain on connections. Improperly made up connections, e.g., worn or mismatched components, wrong pressure rating, etc., not able to cope with this increased load can fail catastrophically. Shock loading. A significant change in the flow rate or pressure during an operation, such as the emergency closure of a valve, causes a sudden extra load or jolt on the system. The temporary increase of load on the system usually imposes increased pressure, vibration, and bending forces on the system. During this period of shock loading, any substandard part of the system, an inferior pipe, worn connections, mismatched connections, wrong pressure rated equipment can fail with potentially disastrous consequences. Hazardous fluids. While there are many physical factors, such as pressure, temperature, and flow rates, that must be considered when dealing with temporary pipework, chemical factors such as hazardous fluids must also be taken into account. Many fluids used in operations, such as brines or acids, are corrosive to temporary pipework and will cause a reduction in wall thickness. It is important that all pipework and connections used have been properly maintained, inspected, and certified before use. Standard service components shall not be used on sour service wells, wells where hydrogen sulfide H2S is present, as this will cause stress corrosion, cracking, and pitting in the metal, as well as destroying any elastomer seals in unions, etc. These factors can lead to premature failure under pressure of components in the system. Conventional hammer union pipework hookup direction of flow. By convention, the flow enters the pipework on the female subside and circulates from the female sub to the male sub. All testing services equipment is manufactured to adhere to this convention and it should be followed whenever possible. However, there is no technical requirement for this convention, and under certain circumstances, such as in a complex rig up or due to crossover availability, It may be required to rig up a line where the direction of flow is reversed. Any such line where the direction of flow is reversed must be clearly marked as to the true direction of flow. Leaks, erosion. Erosion takes place in flow systems where turbulence occurs, typically in pipe ends, e.g., elbows, tube constrictions, e.g., chokes or valves, and other structures that alter flow direction, such as laterals or T's. Specific erosion points within these components can vary depending on the fluid velocity and size of any suspended particles. With typically sized sand grains, the erosion point in a bend is usually past the midpoint of the bend. And it is for this reason that wall thickness is measured at the 80 to 90 degree point as well as at 45 degrees. Erosion can lead to leakage and a rapid failure, and it is therefore important that the layout is designed, where possible, to minimize bends and constrictions and that such areas are inspected regularly. Examples where erosion can be accelerated are connections or downstream of the choke points where the flow line is redirected. H2S. When H2S is present, the system is known as sour, and sour service equipment shall be used for working pressure above 6000 psi. Sour service equipment has significantly lower rated cold working pressure than the equivalent standard service equipment, and it is therefore important to avoid mixing standard and sour service equipment in the same operation.